All right, guys, that's four in a row for the Utah Jazz. This is Hanson James, and this is the SLC Dunk postgame show. This was a big win tonight for the Utah Jazz because this was one of the tougher games in their for their remaining schedule. The Jazz have some pretty big teams they're going to play for the rest of the year, but this was one of those kind of 50-50 games. And if the Jazz could find a way to win this game, it was big time in them getting a playoff spot this year. And so beating the Indiana Pacers, who are a really good team in the Eastern Conference, was big for the Jazz. I want to talk a little bit about the Pacers, and then I want to talk, obviously, about the Utah Jazz. But I'm a fan of Victor Oladipo. Tonight, I actually learned some things about him that I guess I kind of knew, but he really solidified it tonight. Victor Oladipo is really good, and not just for his offensive game, 24 points a game or something like that for the Pacers this year, which is really impressive. To score that many points, you have to be good. You have to be talented, and you have to be efficient, and he absolutely was. In this day and age, you can't get away with just taking random buckets. And so Victor Oladipo has legitimately turned into a great all-star, but he had five steals tonight. Victor Oladipo was really, really good tonight. I know his shooting percentage wasn't that great, but that guy carries that offense, and he's really good. So shout out to the Pacers, who did incredibly well for themselves with that Paul George trade. I'm sure Pacer fans have talked about this endlessly, but really impressive what they've turned Victor Oladipo into and what he has done for himself. I mean, the work he's put in is incredible. So shout out to the Pacers. But the Jazz dominated them tonight, so it didn't matter. Turner had a great game for the Pacers. Victor Oladipo had a really nice offensive game or defensive game. Offensively, he wasn't all that efficient, but still pretty good. The Jazz were just great, and there were two players. I mean, obviously, Donovan Mitchell was himself. The fact that Donovan Mitchell scores 20-plus points a game every game is unbelievable, and he's a rookie. I mean, we've said every night, I mean, we could just talk about Donovan Mitchell every night because it's incredible what he's doing as a rookie, just 20-plus points per game. So Donovan Mitchell, just incredible every night. The consistency as a rookie is just remarkable. And it's just going to get better. That's what's crazy. He's going to get better. You can see the ways that he's going to get better. But tonight, and we'll talk a little about Ricky Rubio, who was also very, very good tonight. But Joe Ingles is dominant. And don't think I didn't read your comments and your angry mention Ingles. Guess what? Ingles is incredible. But tonight, he was just phenomenal. Joe Ingles ended the Pacers in the third quarter. Just, he guillotined them. He came in and just every offensive possession, just either he made a bucket, the alley-oop to Rudy Gobert, assisting, hitting threes, just running the game. And then defensively, he was so good. He is such a good defender. And one of the things that Joe Ingles does so well as a defender is he just uses his size and length so well. He's 6'8". When you go watch the Jazz in person, if you go lower bowl, if you have a chance to do that, you'll notice that Joe Ingles is big. I mean, he is up there. He's bigger than like Trevor Booker. He's big. He's almost up there as tall as Derek Favors. And he knows how to use that size and that length. Like, there's a reason he gets the steals. He's a smart, crafty defender, but he's also strong and he blocks shots. He's just a great defender because he understands spacing. He maximizes his length and size perfectly to defend every player, whether it's isolation or off-ball defense. He's phenomenal. There's a reason his plus-minus is always through the roof. And it's just strange when his plus-minus, whenever it's down, it's weird. Because overall, Joe Ingles is one of the smartest players in the NBA. Might be the smartest player in the NBA. And then you add the fact that he's a 45% three-point shooter. He's an incredible passer. He runs that pick and roll incredibly, and he uses that length and size to score at the rim. So his ability to extend, there we go. How do we do this? Extend at the hoop and either hit the shot or get an alley-oop to Rudy Gobert is remarkable. He's just a total package, top 10 NBA small forward. There's not 10 guys better than Joe Ingles. Maybe there's 5 or 6, but there's not 10. I can tell you that. It might be less than that. It might be top 5. I don't know. I mean, how many of them are shooting as good as he is, defend as well, and run the pick and roll? He's remarkable. And then Rudy Gobert was absolutely a force to be reckoned with tonight. His offense has become so dominant. He's catching. I'm going to pull up his stats tonight. But his offense is so good for two reasons. He finishes at the rim with incredible efficiency, whether it's dunking it, layups, or tonight he had that little floater. And I talked about it in the downbeat a few days ago. Go to slc.com and read all the articles. I hope you're doing this. But he's becoming a shooter. He shoots better than Ben Simmons from 16 feet to the three-point line. So the long mid-range shot, Rudy Gobert shoots like 50% on the year. albeit it's on 8 shots, that's still something to watch. So Rudy Gobert's offense is incredible. The other reason he's so good is he sets such good picks. His picks are incredible. And when you add the fact that Donovan has that speed and he has just a wall to work with that just creates open space for Donovan to work, there's a reason Rudy Gobert makes the offense better. It's better. Just phenomenal. But Rudy Gobert tonight was 23 points, 14 rebounds, one block. The fact that Rudy gets any blocks is pretty remarkable. When you consider how many people don't go into the hoop against him, he's a shutdown corner that people don't even want to face. So the fact that he gets blocks at all, it's incredible. John Smith, if the Nuggets lose tonight, it's a three-way tie for the eighth spot, and we got tiebreakers. That was kind of weird. I don't know why I did that. I'm very sorry. Misty Snow. Gobert has been our leading scorer since the break. Been grabbing huge double-doubles like every night. Lots of 20-plus point games. Yes, Gobert is a double-double machine. If Gobert plays 32 minutes a night, there's no reason he doesn't get 10-10. Minimum. You know, but Gobert's presence is just everything, whether it's on offense, creating screens and allowing the screener to go around and get open space. And then he rolls to the rim like it's just a dominant hurricane, or on defense, he just closes all gaps and ends all dreams. And if they actually decide to go at him, they die. That's literally what happens. They literally die. Like, I think their heart just kind of goes like this and they die. That you die. You're dead. That's what happens when you go against Rudy Gobert. Don't mess with Rudy Gobert, and he should be Defensive Player of the Year, because if they're going to give a Defensive Player of the Year to Kawhi, who missed like 20 games 2 or 3 years ago, they should give it to Rudy Gobert, right? They really should. All right, guys, I think that's everything. Just a dominant win for the Utah Jazz, who are just showing just such a business-like, machine-like victory night after night. The Jazz are back, by the way. Tonight was just a clear... clear reminder, the Jazz are back from All-Star break. They had two or three games there where they did not look quite right, and that's why they lost a couple. Tonight, the Jazz just looked like down to business. Like, we're not messing around with this team. We're going to win. There's nothing you can do. We're going to score. We're going to defend, and we're going to come away with a victory. And I have no doubts that the Jazz make the playoffs. This was the 50-50 game they needed, and they got it. Jazz going to the playoffs, guys. Get ready. Don't get angry at me if I jinx it, but I'm pretty sure. Anyways, like and subscribe this channel, guys. Like it. Subscribe. Also, go to slcdunk.com. Read all the articles. Take your finger. Go like this. Click, 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 click. Read all the articles. Search SLC Dunk on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. All of it. Read all of it. Follow all the writers. Follow me. My name's @HansonJames. I'm a fan of the Jazz, and so are you. That's why you're probably listening to this. Or maybe you're a Pacers fan. Pacer fans, you're ready to join the Jazz fan. Dumb? Do it. All right, guys. I will talk to you later.